Jim and swiped the old rag over the counters again, cleaning off any stray crumbs off the display glass. Jimin worked at a small popular pet store downtown of Seoul. He greeted everyone with a smile, ready to make someone happy or even brighten someone's day. The bell above the door chimed, and Jimin looked up. "Junker key," the short male exclaimed, smiling brightly. "What's it this time?" The customer grinned, leaning on the counter. "Jiminy, I forgot some treats for my rabbit. Do you have any recommendations?" Jungkook was already pulling his wallet from his back pocket. Jimin nodded. "I'll be right back." The male disappeared into the back, returning a few minutes later with a jar of bacon flavored treats. "Here you go." Jungkook gratefully accepted the jar, exchanging some bills. "Keep the change." Jungkook smiled, calling out a goodbye to his friend. Jimin sighed, glancing at the clock. Just a few more minutes and his shift would be over. The male busied himself with wiping the counters off, glancing at the clock. He was tired today, wanting to go home and take a nap. The clock struck 6, and Jimin clocked out, grabbing his coat and rushing out the door. He was excited to get home, probably take a long nap and cook himself a small meal. The small male suddenly yelped, falling to the ground and scraping his knees through the ripped pants he wore. He hissed, having also unfortunately scraped some of the skin from his palms. A loud sound erupted from behind him, startling Jimin. It was obnoxious, almost sounding like an electric pencil sharpener. It rose in volume before quieting, causing Jimin to sit up from where he had fallen on the sidewalk. He glanced around, confused over where the sound had come from and what he had possibly tripped over in his haste to get home. He spotted a box, medium in size, flipped over in the middle of the sidewalk. Standing while also ignoring the ache in his knees, Jimin picked up the cardboard thing, nearly dropping it, when the sound erupted forth again. Something small scurried into a small pink pouch, catching Jimin's eye. The sound, crabbing, Jimin believed it was called, halted once the small animal reached the fabric pouch. Jimin crouched, setting the box to the side, and glancing at the other items that had scattered when Jimin had tripped over the box. There were several cloths, all different shades of blue and pink that had been packed into the box. Jimin gathered them up, putting back inside the box. Bottles of special food had rolled everywhere, and Jimin ended up losing one before he could catch them all. He reached for the small pouch, flinching a bit when the crabbing started up again. Jimin glanced around, feeling foolish. He looked down at the pouch. Jimin gave a soft whistle, carefully lifting the pouch from the ground. At this point, Jimin was sure the poor animal had been abandoned, put outside the pet shop for a reason. He reached a small finger into the bag, smiling when he felt a wet nose. Jimin cooed, drawing the animal out. Only, it wasn't an animal. It was a little adorable sugar glider hybrid, full-fledged in its adult years. Flower petal ears flicked back in distress and big wide eyes scanning over Jimin. The little hybrid was shaking, scared beyond belief. Jimin cooed, holding his palm out for the hybrid to climb onto. "You're so cute." Jimin shielded the small glider from the wind, reaching to pet the soft brown hair. The hybrid held tightly onto Jimin's thumb, small hands gripping tightly. His long tail curled around Jimin's wrist. He had on a cute flimsy pink sweater, making it impossible to tell if the hybrid had the flaps sugar gliders used to glide with. Jimin held the small hybrid close, eyes scanning the street. Who would leave a cute hybrid here? Jimin saw no one. That could've been the owner, a frown crossing his face. "Why were you abandoned?" The male reached to scratch under the glider's chin, noting the plump lips and cute handsome face. "Poor thing." The hybrid gave a soft clicking note, eyes falling shut. Jimin stood up, placing the pouch in the box, before picking that up too. He held the glider close, re-entering the pet shop. Going to the back, he knocked on a closed door. "Yoongi Hyung?" Jimin voiced quietly. "Come in, Jiminy," a low voice called. Jimin pushed through the closed door. "I tripped outside, and I fell over this box." Jimin set the box down on Yoongi's desk, and this hybrid. Jimin held the little guy out for Yoongi to see. "I tripped outside, and I fell over this box." Jimin set the box down on Yoongi's desk, and this hybrid. Jimin held the little guy out for Yoongi to see. The blonde-haired male eyed the small thing. "A sugar glider? These hybrids are so expensive that not even selling my entire shop could help me afford one. And you just found one," Yoongi stated incredulously. "Yeah. I think he's hurt. The poor thing's shaking to death. Jimin fretted, his love for animals coming out. Yoongi nodded. Let me see. Jimin handed the small hybrid over, the glider immediately starting to crab at Yoongi. Yoongi clicked his tongue. He's terrified, that's for sure. I'll give him a checkup. But you'll have to take him home. Jimin nodded. And clean yourself up, your knees are bleeding, Jimin. Yoongi scolded. Jimin ducked his head, exiting the room for the bathroom. If only we wasn't so clumsy. One of his flaps was torn, which is most likely the reason he was left outside the shop. I've stitched it up, so he's going to be in discomfort for a bit. Yoongi informed him. Here's some pain medicine he should take every 6 hours. He can't be left alone. Sugar gliders are social creatures. He can die if he doesn't have a stable social bond. Jimin nodded, storing the important information. If you look closely on his hair, the middle section is darker than the rest, as if to mimic the stripe on an actual sugar glider. Yoongi pointed towards the stripe. Sugar glider hybrids don't speak, but on rare occasion, preferring to bark, sing or purr instead. And Jimin? Jimin yanked his head up, blonde hair bouncing. Yeah? His name is Jin.